Then recording will start. Okay. So we are into the unsteady state. So we know in unsteady state, temperature is a function of time and location. Okay. Now under unsteady state, we have two categories, as I said. Number one category, I had taken a body in which undergoes a cooling process, and we found that the temperature is decreasing with respect to the time. But we found that the temperature drops is dropping, which is having a uniform temperature after a time interval. That is, when the time get increases, we get the same temperature throughout the body. And then in category two, we have a same body which is undergoes a cooling process, and when the time is equal to zero, so the temperature at all the location are same. As the time increases, then you can see the temperature drop at different location is different. So x1, x2, x3. So we have a different temperature after a time interval. So I can say this is happening in two, in category one, because it has a low internal thermal resistance. So if you have a low internal thermal resistance, in that case, the temperature will be uniform throughout the body. And I had given you the example of a small body, or we can say a body which has a small path length for a heat flow. So ball bearing, it has a small path length for the heat flow. So we consider the internal resistance to be small. So I was just trying to make you understand, we have a two resistance come into a picture. Okay. So this is your resistance one, RTH. So it is called to be internal resistance. Okay. So this is a plain wall. In a plane wall, this is called as internal resistance, and this is called a surface resistance. Okay. So these two resistances come into a picture. If this resistance is low or negligible, so amount of temperature at this position and this position will remain the same. If this resistance is high, the temperature drop will be shown. Are you getting me? So temperature T1 will be equal to temperature T2. So we consider there is T1 temperature throughout the body, as the internal resistance is negligible. Now this will happen when we have a body of category one, where the path length through which heat is flowing is very small. So in that condition, we consider a small ball bearing and a thermocouple which has a temperature is a function of time, not location. So entire location we have a same temperature. So in case of large body, if I take a meat, here I given you the example of, if I take a big piece of meat, so if you heat this meat, when you keep in the open atmosphere, if I touch this meat, I can feel a different temperature at different location. So temperature is a function of time as well as location. Now, if you have a problem of this type, how to identify? That is the main condition. If you have a problem where you come to know that the body, where from a body, the heat flow path length is very small. So in that condition, we have a one dimensionless number, we call to be a Biot number. So if I have a body, we have to calculate the Biot number, which has a formula of HLC/K. And with this value, we check if Biot number is less than or equal to 0.1. Then what we do, we apply this lump system formula that we're going to derive. Okay. And if your Biot number is greater than 0.1, then we do not solve it by lump theory. We solve it by different methodology we adopted. So one of the methodology is we use Hiessler chart to solve the problem, to find out the temperature as well as the heat flow through that body. Are you getting me? So these are the two cases. So we're going to solve one when the Biot number is less than 0.1. So it is called as lump system. Or lumped body. When your Biot number is greater than 0.1, then it is called as Hiessler chart. So there are two categories, two ways we solve the problems. So one is lump system, one is the Hester chart. These are the two topics which is there in your unsteady state. So we're going to first cover up the lump system. We'll derive the equation from this. We'll take that equation and we can solve the problems. So condition is Biot number should be less than 0.1. Other problem, if you have a problem, we'll calculate the Biot number with this formula and we check if the value of Biot number is greater than 0.1, then we use Hester chart methodology to solve that problem. I hope it is understood to everyone. Now based on this, we can proceed with the derivations. Okay, now we'll have one derivation based on unsteady state, that is Hester chart. So we are into the topic of unsteady state. Heat conduction. So in which we'll have a derivation which is heat conduction in solid having infinite thermal conductivity. Or we can say negligible internal resistance. Okay. So this we have to remember. Negligible internal resistance. Or we can call it to be as lumped system analysis. So in exam, either you can get a topic of derivation on lump system analysis, or you can have the entire derivation on heat conduction in solid having an infinite thermal conductivity or negligible internal resistance, which means one and the same. Okay. Now I will be sharing you a notes on this. You can refer it for the theory. So I can only tell you what is the lump system in few words. So whenever we have a process in which the internal resistance is assumed negligible in comparison when its surface resistance. So whenever we have a body whose internal resistance, if this is the body and it undergoes a cooling process. So as I told you, we have a two resistance, internal resistance and surface resistance. So whenever I can say the process in which the internal resistance is assumed negligible. Compare with the external or surface resistance. Okay, then it is called as Newtonian heating and cooling process. Newtonian heating and cooling process. Okay, so under this process, the temperature in this process is considered to be uniform at a given time. Okay. And it is called as such analysis is called as lump parameter analysis. So whenever we have a body whose internal resistance is considered to be negligible or having a infinite thermal conductivity, K is infinite, then we consider that the internal resistance is negligible compared with the surface resistance. And in such conditions, the system is considered to be a lump system. Okay, so under a lump system we're going to have one derivation. So for theory part you can refer to the notes or RK Rajpur. So we consider one derivation in which I consider a body. So we start with a derivation. Let us consider. Consider a body whose initial temperature is Ti, is the initial temperature throughout. It means a body, it has initial temperature throughout the body, and which is placed suddenly in ambient. In ambient air or any liquid at Ta as shown in figure. So Ta is the ambient temperature. So whatever we had considered, I just draw it for you. So we had considered a body which is at initial temperature as Ti. So I consider this is the body. Okay. So I consider this is the body or a system. So who has the initial temperature as Ti, and I consider rho is the density of the body, V is the volume of the body, and C is the specific heat of the body. And this body, it has a negligible internal thermal resistance. Negligible internal thermal resistance. I hope it is understood by everyone. So I consider a body whose internal resistance is negligible, that is RTH. So we do not consider the RTH. So if you do not consider the RTH, it means the temperature Ti, it is uniform throughout the body. So at any location, whether this location, or this location, it has a Ti as a uniform temperature. Okay. Now, as this is the initial temperature, so I can say as Ti is greater than Ta. So this is the ambient temperature. So as the initial temperature of the body is greater, so amount of energy will be released to the ambient. Okay. So I can consider this as lumped heat capacity system. I hope it is understood what we are doing. I had considered a body which has an initial temperature Ti throughout the body. Now this will happen when the body has a small path length. So it means it has a negligible internal resistance. An amount of heat is flows from the body to the surrounding as the initial temperature is greater than the ambient temperature. So how it can go out? This can be go in terms of convection. So Q of convection that we have to consider. So what is the convection formula? It is H A del of T. So H A S into del of T. So del of T will be T minus T A. It will be not T I minus T A, because Ti is the temperature of a body when time is equal to zero. So as the time increases, Ti will get changed to T, that is T. So T is the temperature of body at any time. So now this will also be equal to minus rho V C into dT by dt. Now, how we got this equation? this equation, it is called as amount of energy stored in the body. So if you heat any body, so body will store some amount of energy. So that amount of energy stored, it is depend on the mass of the body, specific heat of the body, and rise in temperature per unit time. So as we know, density is mass upon volume. So what we do is mass is replaced with density into volume. So we have here as density into volume as mass into specific heat into change of temperature with respect to time. That is rise in temperature per unit time. That is called energy stored in the body. So any body will have a same formula to calculate the amount of energy stored in the body. That is the mass of the body, specific heat of the body, and rise in temperature per unit time. So same thing you had considered. Now here we have a minus as the amount of energy is released by the body to the ambient. So with these two equation will have a derivation to have equation. So we can continue. So I can say the transient. What do you mean by transient? It means for a short duration of time. So under an unsteady state heat conduction, so it can also we have a word as transient. It means the amount of heat or amount of temperature changes from a body at a very short duration. That is after 2 seconds, 5 seconds. So if I want to calculate the transient responses of the body, so I can get the transient response of the body. Can be determined as follows. So we have Q is the amount of heat released to the ambient. So it is equal to, we can have minus rho VC into dT by d tau, which is also equal to H AS del of T, that is T minus Is it understood? The same equation, whatever we had written here, same equation I had considered, because Q is the amount of heat released from the body. So whatever the amount of heat stored in the body, same amount of heat is getting released. So by convection formula and by energy stored equation, I had written here. Now with this two equation, if I rearrange this two equation, so it can be rearranged as dT upon T minus TA is equal to minus H AS upon rho VC into d tau. So that is by rearranging. So you can write it by rearranging, you will get this. So if I integrate both the equation, so it will be ln of T minus TA is equal to minus H AS is a constant upon rho VC, so into tau plus C1 as constant. So in order to get the value of C1, we'll apply the boundary condition. So applying boundary condition.
Sir, can you show above equation at the Q1?
Yeah. This one? This equation? Yes.
No, sir. The below one.
This one.
Yes, sir.
Same equation. Whatever I written here, the same as copied here. Q is the amount of heat released to the ambient. So it is the amount of energy stored in the body, and it is released from the surface of the body. That is Newton's law of convection and the energy stored formula. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Proceed. Same, I had rearranged,
yes, yes, sir.
And I integrated. So if you want, you can write it here as by rearranging and by integrating. So by rearranging and by integrating, you will get this equation. So here C1 is constant. To get the value of C1, we apply the boundary condition. So what is the boundary condition? When time is equal to 0, so you can apply the boundary condition. When time is equal to 0, my temperature of the body is equal to Ti. So as the time increases, the temperature will be the function of time, that we all know. So we require only first boundary condition. When time is equal to 0, my body temperature was the initial Ti. So if I apply this boundary condition in the above equation, in this equation, I will get the value of C1. So I can write from equation 1. So if I apply it, I will get, if I put time is equal to 0, at this place the entire time will be 0 and T will replace first Ti. So I can write directly C1 is equal to ln of Ti minus Ta. And if I substitute in equation 1, so what I will get? I will get ln of T minus Ta is equal to, then refer it back, it is equal to minus HAS. So it will be minus HAS upon rho VC plus into tau plus C1. So into tau plus C1, that is ln of Ti minus Ta. So again, if I rearrange, I can see ln on both the side. So if I rearrange, it will be ln of this term minus ln of this term. So if I take ln to be common, so I can write this divide. So I can write as, so I can write directly ln of T minus Ta ln of T minus Ta upon Ti minus Ta. And this is equal to minus HAS tau upon rho VC. Is it understood? So if I write in terms of exponential term, then it can be written as, T minus Ta upon Ti minus Ta, which is equal to exponential term of minus HAS tau upon rho VC. So this is your term. And this Ta minus Ta can be also written as theta, and Ti minus Ta can also be written as theta I, where theta represent the unaccomplished temperature difference and theta I represent the maximum temperature difference. Okay. Now this can call to be your temperature distribution equation of a body. So I can consider this equation to be your final expression. So this expression is to be remembered. So this is your equation number 2. So we can name this equation as, it is a temperature distribution in a body. So I can write the above equation gives temperature distribution in the body. Are you getting me? If suppose your time is known, if suppose we have a body and you have to heat this body, and you have to heat this body for a 5 minutes. So what is the temperature after 5 minutes of this body? You can get it from this expression. So this is the temperature, will depend on the time. So after 5 minutes, what is the temperature? You can get it from this expression. That is when you go for a cooling process or a heating process. So based on the time, you can get the temperature of the entire body. Is it understood? So this equation is called a temperature distribution in the body. Okay. And body for this you have to remember for Newtonian heating and cooling process. Okay. So we understood what is Newtonian heating and cooling. It means we had considered negligible internal resistance of the body. So if you have a body whose internal resistance is negligible, then only you can apply that equation to calculate. Otherwise, you cannot apply. So based on this, so it also indicate, if I plot it on the x and y axis, so it indicates that temperature rises exponentially with time. As shown in figure. Okay. So what is written here? That temperature, this expression also shows that temperature rises exponentially with time. Are you getting me? So we have a exponentially means what? This is the temperature and this is the exponential time with time. So if you resolve it, you will come to know that your temperature increases exponentially with time if you go under a heating process. If you go under a cooling process, your temperature decreases exponentially with time. So if I plot it on the x and y axis, so I will get this type of equation. So if suppose I am considering temperature versus a time. So this represents the time tau. And this represents the temperature. Okay. Now if suppose our body it is initially at high temperature, that is it undergoes a cooling process. So it undergoes a cooling process, so we'll have a exponential of cooling. Okay. So we'll get a diagram of this term. What is? So we call it to be the exponential cooling. So we can write here as exponential cooling. And it is cooled till your temperature TA. And if it undergoes a heating process, so I can say it get heated exponentially. So here I can say this is my temperature as TA. Now my temperature TA. Now consider this. So this is my temperature T. And this will be your exponentially heating. Are you getting me? So with that expression, we'll come to know that whether it undergoes a cooling process or heating process, it will undergo exponentially cooling and exponentially heating. And we can have the name of this figure to be Newtonian heating or cooling. It's called as Newtonian heating or cooling. Now this is the final expression we got. This expression that we have to remember to solve the equation. Okay. Now if I want to further simplify this term in terms of dimensionless number, so how I can do? Minus HS tau upon rho VC if I take only this term. Okay. So the quantity minus or H A S tau upon rho V C can be arranged in dimensionless form. As follows. So how I can arrange? So from this quantity, I require a dimensionless term. With the help of that term, I can identify whether the body undergoes a lump system or it's a huge body. So if I take the entire term as H A S tau upon rho B C, and if I multiply and divide. If I multiply and divide by V, that is volume, surface area, and thermal conductivity with this three term. So I will be getting, if I write the final expression, I will be getting as, okay, so I will be getting two dimensionless from this. One is H LC upon K, which is called to be a Biot number, and second I will be getting as alpha tau upon LC square. So these are the two terms I will be getting. These represent your Biot number, this represent your Fourier number. Now how we have to rearrange? We have to go with H LC by K. So H LC is volume upon surface area into K. So this is your one term, and your other term will be alpha. So alpha is K upon rho C and tau, and LC square is equal to volume upon surface area. So we will have a surface area square upon volume square. So you got A square K is K into tau upon rho V square into C. So if you consider this, with this you will understand that we have volume, surface area into K. So we are multiplied and divided. So we have one volume and we have one volume here. We can divide, cancel, and then surface area and K. So we have 1K and 1K. That is way to rearrange in terms of dimensionless number. So we'll get this. If I get into LC, so what is this term? We have a two new term, that is this and alpha. So where alpha is thermal diffusivity. So alpha is equal to K upon rho C. It is a formula and it is known as thermal diffusivity. So what is thermal diffusivity? So if any material have a higher thermal diffusivity, the higher or the faster the heat diffuses from the material. If the material have a low thermal diffusivity, the heat will diffuses slowly from that body. And based on this, we have a LC. So LC, it is volume upon surface area. So it is known as characteristic length. So for any body, if you have a cylinder, sphere, plane wall, cube, we have to apply the volume upon surface area to get the characteristic length. Okay. Now, from above equation, I can say the quantity HLC upon K is equal to BI, which is known as Biot number. Okay. And the quantity that is alpha tau upon LC square is equal to FO, which indicate as Fourier number. So these are the two terms which we got, and that will be replaced with this quantity that we had already derived in the above equation. So we're going to replace this with Biot number and Fourier number, and the equation can be rewrite as, so I can rewrite the above equation as theta upon theta I is equal to T minus T A upon T I minus T A is equal to exponential of minus Biot number into Fourier number. It means that in order to calculate the temperature of a body with respect to the time, at any time, you can use this expression, either the above expression or this expression, but most preferably you can go with the above equation. So these two expressions are important that we have to learning. Okay, so it is also known as temperature distribution equation of a body, where you can calculate the temperature of a body at any time. Is it understood? Any doubt till here? So this is your derivation. What we did is we had considered the same instantaneous heat flow rate and total heat transfer. So we'll first consider the instantaneous heat flow rate, QI. So rho VC dT upon d tau and rho VC d upon d tau. So T we are considering from the above equation. So this equation we have simplified and the above content we have taken here. And if you take a derivative of this, we'll get this. If I resolve, we'll get the final expression for your QI. So this is the final expression that we have to remember whenever they ask you to calculate instantaneous heat flow rate. So what do you mean by instantaneous heat flow rate? It means that heat transfer at a given time. If I ask you, if suppose we have a cup of coffee and it is getting cooled, and if they ask you to calculate the amount of heat transfer after 2 minutes. So we have to take a time of 2 minutes and then we have to calculate. So this is the heat transfer at a given time. So this is the amount of at a given time. So we have to calculate the amount of heat flow at a given time. So what is the amount of heat is flowing after 2 minutes? So aapko ye equation use karna. After 2 minutes, what is the amount of heat flow? That is instantaneous heat flow rate. Okay, and if they ask you to calculate total amount of heat flow, then you have to go with the other equation. Okay, then you can have a total or cumulative heat flow. Heat transfer. So we consider to be either QT we can consider. I can use the notation of RK as per Q dash. So if I make use of this equation, so Q dash is the total amount of heat flow after 2 minutes, that is from 0 to 2 minutes. So what I have to do is I have to take an integration of QI, that is from 0 to tau. So it can be from 0 to 2 minutes or whatever the time is given. Are you getting me? So we have the equation of QI just now we had proved. I can write here as integration from 0 to tau, and the equation for QI is minus HAS, so minus HAS into TI minus TA into exponential of minus HAS tau upon rho VC. So we'll take an integration of this. So into T tau. So this will be into T tau. So we'll take a derivation, sorry, integration of the entire term. That is, we have to calculate the total heat flow from 0 to 2 minute or 5 minute, whatever time is given. So if I apply the integration, minus HAS is common, TI minus TA is also common, and this will be exponential of minus HAS tau upon rho VC divided by HAS upon rho VC. Now here I can see my HAS is can be cancelled. So the left part is minus rho VC. So if I write it directly, so it can be from 0 to tau. And if I write it, so I'll be getting my rho VC as minus minus will get cancelled in both the cases. So here also we have a minus. So I can write this rho VC. Yeah, TI minus T. Any doubt? Yeah, if I apply exponential with minus HAS tau upon rho VC and minus 1. As I'm applying my boundary condition from 0 to tau. Is it clear? So this is your term that is cumulative or total rate of heat transfer. That is rho VC TI minus TA into exponential of minus power number into Fourier number. In this way also the rho e raised to minus Biot number into Fourier number and minus 1. Is it understood? So about terms mean the same, only you have to consider the boundary lines. So this is your one term and this is your entire term. If you apply the boundary condition, if you apply the limit of 0 to tau. So if you apply the limit from 0 to tau, the first take the time as tau, so you will get exponential of minus HAS tau upon rho VC. If I apply the second limit of 0, so if I put tau as 0, so it will be e raised to 0 will be 1, so it will be minus 1. Understood? Okay. So based on this, you can have the equation, you can remember. So these are the two equations. So most probably you can use this equation to solve the problem. I can say they are important equations. So this will give you total amount of heat transfer. This will give you a total amount of heat transfer during 2 minutes. And this will give you your instant amount of heat transfer after 2 minutes. Are you getting me? So that we have to consider in this way. So these are the two equations that we have to consider.